again. Da, da, da.
Welcome back to Storytime. Don't know why I gave it a proper introduction, but why not? Today I am here to talk about meeting the Buffy cast, especially Mark Blucas and Anthony Head. And I say especially, they're the only people I'm going to be talking about this video, so you can tell I don't script these. Yeah, so the first time I saw Mark and Anthony was in the Buffy live talk, so I got to see that before meeting them, which was so cool because it let me get a feel for them. It was actually really interesting for me to see Mark, because Mark plays Riley on Buffy, who is, to a lot of people, a really disliked character. For me, I don't really dislike him because I understand his purpose. You know, you're not supposed to love him as much as you loved Angel. It's supposed to be that Buffy can't truly connect with a normal human soul because she's not normal. She doesn't live in that world, not completely. And so for me, even in Riley's faults, I'm not like, ah, Riley, yep. But I know for a lot of people, they can't understand it for a storytelling purpose, and they're just like, oh, that guy, But I actually really like Riley, especially when he comes back into it, because he's calmer and he's happier and he's kind of found some good things in his life. And I'm like, yes, you do you, Riley. And so hearing him talk at Comic-Con, it was actually, I think, the first Comic-Con he said he'd ever attended, the first or second, maybe. But that he never knows what to expect because he knows that he's so hated as Riley. And he said that back in the day when he filmed Buffy, Joss would say to him, oh, don't go on the internet or don't open those magazines because there was so much hate. And I think for him to continue to play a character that has had so much hate against and still be proud to say I was on the show, I think is amazing, because it could be very easy to just be like, oh, I don't talk about Buffy, but what? But he's not. He's like, you know what? I was on this great show. People didn't really like me. But for me, from my perspective, I do like Riley, and I like when he comes back and he's in a happy, normal relationship, as opposed to the dysfunctional, trying to keep up with the Slayer kind of thing that happened. But yeah, it was really funny, and he was almost like flirting with Anthony Head. It was just really funny, like he kept joking that Anthony was a sex magnet, and no, not sex magnet, what was it? I can't remember, but it was just really sweet, and they obviously had a very good relationship. And when I saw him meeting people later on, he was so excited. Everyone was like actually really crazy about him, and I think a lot of people had seen him in the talk and heard his side of the story that he wasn't liked and this and the other, and I think a lot of people were like, oh, I want to talk to him now. And so when I met him, technically, I hadn't met him, like I'd taken a picture with him very briefly. And when I kind of met him more properly, I was in the middle of talking to Claire Kramer. So as I was talking to Claire, this person walked past and kind of whacked into my shoulder. And I turned around to be like, what? And he was like, it's you! And I was like, it's you! And he was like, I'm going to see you later. I was like, no, I'll see you first. And you know, and you're like, I just played around and joked with Mark Blucas that it's so cool. And he was so nice to all the fans that he was talking to. Like, he was giving everyone so much time. And I think it's because he really appreciates it now, and he can kind of look back at it fondly because he's not in the midst of all the emotion he had at the time when he was disliked. I understand that the stars have to charge good amounts of money because they need to make it profitable, but he was literally selling selfies for like £5. So everyone's just like, yeah, I'll take a selfie with Mark Blucas. And I got a selfie as well, which is on my phone somewhere. But the professional photo I got, he was introducing himself to every person. He was like, oh, what's your name? And they'd be like, oh, I'm Laura or so on. And he'd be like, oh, I'm Mark. And it's like, everyone knows who you are, Mark. Everyone knows. But it was really sweet because then he introduced him and then he like was like, oh, I love this, and like kind of like scratched my head. But it was really sweet, and I was just kind of like, yeah, me too. I've actually had a lot of celebrities tell me that they like my shaved head, which is quite cool. I think because to them it stands out. I don't look necessarily like every other person, so I always like when people do it, I'm like, yeah, I like it too. It was funny though when I got the autograph from him. Because we'd spoke a bit about my broken arm and he'd kind of like made a couple of jokes about it, but in a very sweet way. And so the autograph says, "Caroline, the broken one. So fun meeting you in Wales, feel better." And it was so sweet, and it was kind of funny because he was like, "I bet you wanted to say the chosen one." I was like, "You know what? I can deal with the broken one. The broken one's quite nice," because he didn't just write the standard Buffy line. He actually made it a part of my situation, so I could actually be like, "Oh, yeah." I think Riley was a relationship that Buffy really needed at the time. She needed to exist in the human world more. And so I think that for her, it was the right choice. But I also think it was the right choice that it ended. But still, Buffy and Angel Forever, that's my end. Like, that's my ultimate OTP, I would say. I don't often hear OTP being used in videos that aren't anime, but I'm just going to do it. Next, we have Mr. Anthony Head, who I thought I might never meet because he barely does comic cons. He works all the time. And so he's never that available to do them. And so I just had it in my mind. I was like, okay, I'm probably never going to meet Anthony Head, but I can meet as many of them as I can. And then James Masters was supposed to go to the Wells Comic Con, but he had to cancel because his series, The Runaway, got renewed. And so I think they got Anthony in his place because then Anthony was announced last minute, and luckily I was on Facebook at the time when they announced it. So I was instantly like, buy photo shoot tickets. And I got two pictures. But the first time I saw him again was in the talk. And it was so cool because he was the first person to come out on stage. And he kind of like ran out and was just like, and I was just like, oh my God, Anthony. And it was just absolutely amazing. I love Giles so much. I mean, anyone who loves Buffy has got to love Giles. I've never heard someone go, "I hate Giles." I think I'd be like, "Who are you? You're not a Buffy fan. How can you hate Giles?" During the talk, though, he was so sweet, and everyone wanted to ask him questions, and people even asked him to sing, and he sang, and he had really nice chemistry with the rest of the, I wouldn't say the rest of the class, with the rest of the cast. And it was just like a little family, watching a little family on stage. Everyone just like loved each other and was so close. And it was so sweet because it's been like 20 years. They could all just be like, yeah, we worked on a show together once. The first photo that I got with him, the professional photo, he was so sweet and just so kind. And this was the first photo. Golden fox. That was the word I was looking for earlier. He's a golden fox. Yeah, I think that's it. I had the first photo done, and then I told him, I was like, oh, I've got two photos, and he kind of said to me, oh, what do you want to do for the second one? And I was like, I don't know. And then the photographer was kind of like, 3, 2, so Anthony was like, and I was like, and then we got this photo. It's amazing. I love it because it's both of us just being like, I don't know what to do. It's just, I love it because we've got like a really nice one, and then we've got like a really funny joke one that's got the nice joke memory attached to it. And then when I wanted to meet him later that day, everyone wanted to meet him. Like, there was literally thousands upon thousands of people waiting in the queue, and I ended up waiting for like 3 to 4 hours in the blazing sun, and like I burned my forehead. And they were trying to move people through, but every person that was speaking to him was obviously speaking for a long time because he's so popular, and he never does Comic Con, so everyone wanted to say what they wanted to say. And he was supposed to leave for his train at 5 o'clock because he had a train at 6, but he was supposed to leave at 5 and then have some time to either eat or do whatever, go to the train station and go back to London because he was going to be filming in London at like 5 a.m. the next morning. So the fact that he even came all the way to Wales just for one day, and he was supposed to leave at 5, but there were still so many people that wanted to meet him, and he kept being like, okay, I'll stay till 5:05. Okay, I'll stay till 5:10. And by the end of it, he stayed till like 5:45. And was trying his best to meet everyone, and by the end of it, there were still like 20 or so people that didn't get to meet him, but he really pushed it as far as he could go. Like, the people at Comic Con had to get his bags ready and actually drive him to the train station. But when I met him, I'd spent so many hours waiting, and I knew that he was in a rush that I couldn't really speak to him that much because I knew that there was still 40 plus people behind me, and I didn't want to be the person that stopped them having an experience. So when I met him, I had to be quite quick, and I was just like, thank you so much for staying and giving this extra time. Like, he didn't even have time to personalize the autographs because he was literally just trying to get through them as quickly as possible so that at least everyone could briefly meet him. But it was sweet because it had been hours and hours and hours, and then he said to me, oh, how did the second photograph turn out? And I was like, oh, he remembered that we took this together. I look like such an egg in that photo. But that's why I kind of love it, because it's just like, I still can't believe that I met Anthony Head. Like, part of me is still like, what? But it happened, and it's true. And I met the wonderful Mark Lucas as well. This is why I love Comic Con, because it puts me in touch with people that I would never otherwise meet. And I can actually go up to them and be like, thank you. You inspired this, or I really enjoyed your character. And I can get, like, a good time with them and be like, these are my feelings. And then they're often really sweet. And then I go home and then I watch Buffy or I watch whatever show again. And I feel so happy for it. And so I say to anyone, go to Comic Con. There's a lot of queues. There's a lot of waiting. But the payoff is amazing. And though it's great to buy that new iPod. Do people still buy iPods? I don't know. Even though it's great to buy that new iPod or that new phone or whatever, real life experiences like this are so much more valuable, to me anyway. Like, yes, I have all these pictures still, but if anything, you pay for the experience that you have at the time, and then these are just like extra happy bonuses. So I hope to meet more of the Buffy cast in time. I think the only people I haven't met now is Amber Benson, Sarah Michelle Gellar, David Boreanaz, Seth Green. So like 5 people out of the main cast. I may have a chance to meet Amber Benson at some point. Seth Green, I'm not sure about, because he's still really famous in America. I think Sarah and David may be near impossible, but I will try. Thanks, guys.